Okay, next exercise, it's a snatch. In my opinion, it's the most difficult exercise or most technical exercise because it's really quick moment, really ballistic moves, and to learning how it's supposed to be, all these technical points, we have to break it down. And before you learning snatch, I recommend study swings first and overhead position second, because swings, it's like a bottom position, and overhead position when you do press, push press, or one arm jerk, right? You learning how hold the kettlebells overhead position because it's important for a snatch. I show you few reps and we start break it down what's going on in this lift. From the side. Okay. It looks really simple, maybe for somebody difficult, but for me it looks really simple. You just swing the bell between your legs and try to accelerate your power, use your legs, use your back, and put these weights on the top position. And get the rest overhead position, of course. Because swings, it's like a most difficult parts, it's a grip. That's what your, if you call this grip muscle, your wrist, we can call this just muscle, right? In the bottom position, it's most difficult parts. Your legs gonna be okay, your back gonna be okay, your all total condition, your breathing gonna be all right, but grip, if you not do correctly, if you not get rest correctly, overhead position, you're gonna be not gonna make it like long term. We're talking about if one switch, it's much more harder than multi-switch. Okay, let's break it down. If you, of course, you remember like a swings, right? It's a bottom position. It's right here. It's everything same. You lock your finger before you do snatch, right? You lock your finger and try to put the kettlebells overhead position. What's going on here in the bottom? You stayed in a position like pre-jump position, look like you wanna jump, exactly like a swings position. And you pulling the weights from here, basically, right? You do extra swings and go directly to the top. When kettlebells in this position, you're fully bending your legs. You try to be in a pre-jump position, right? And when kettlebell passed your feet, you start pulling. It's not about snatch, it's like a swings. It's like a ballistic movement. It's not about you pulling something. Pull, it's something about like a slow movement, pull. It's not really pull, it's almost like a throw, ballistic moments. And the top position, you try to open your wrist right here to fixate, right? That's your goal. I'm gonna show you slowly, it's really, that's why I get this light bell, it's good. Okay, you pass this point, feet point, and you start fast accelerate your power, And a kettlebell, most of the time, kettlebell really flying on top and fly back too. Look, it's 45 degrees position. It's a it's my recommendation, because best kettlebell lifters in the world in this exercise, them do exactly like a 45 degrees position. I see somebody did this way a little bit, but you can see if you see somebody snatch like that, because them like to do this way. Them not do more than 200 reps with 32 kilograms. That's why it's most record holders do exactly this way, plus minus. That's why it's 45 degrees position. And next, kettlebells fly over there. You in a like a face position right here. You push forward your wrist and try to, it's like a gloves. You try to go inside the bell. And only this finger stopping you. Look. You push forward, not do the same, stay right here and lock your finger. You unlock your finger, push forward and go inside. And it's a head position. And same time, in the top position, you landed kettlebells. And when you practice like push press or press or one arm jerk, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Your wrist gonna be completely open. A lot of people do mistake them pushing. Did you see? Same as like for push press, for one arm jerk or press, it's no reason push the bell, because you get stress on the wrist right here. You open your wrist, you see? When you open your wrist, you have more chance to get rest over head position. Right here. We just talking right now how kettlebell's going up. Again, slowly, really. Chest position, like a face position. And you push forward your wrist inside, and it's already there, right? And you back your to the overhead position and open your wrist. Next point, what's going on? Really, professional athletes, it's look like we stayed, them staying really same. Nothing with your hip, we're not forward, pushed this way or this way. But really for rest, overhead position, how it's work. Yes, it looks like I'm stayed like a straight, but a little bit you can, if you need a rest, if you work in slow pace, you can go, you see, it's like a diagonal. It's like a, this way, you don't need even these legs. It's mean you can stay comfortable, get rest. This way too, but a little bit you're shifting the weights from the right hand to the left feet. You don't have the meaning, it's about rest position, it's like advantage, you know how it's shifting the weights overhead. Right hand, left legs, shifting. It's a little bit you shifting the weights for get comfortable position overhead for rest. Left arm. Right legs. See? This is for get a little bit rest overhead position if you feel comfortable, because when you start slow pace, maybe 12 reps per minute. 12 reps per minute, at least you need 5 seconds to get rest somewhere. I know people even get rest like that, but really it's not correct. If you wanna do get more bonuses from this exercise, you have to do pretty much straight. But you can get rest sometimes when your grip really tire, you want to be really get rest somewhere. And when you're pushing the belts overhead position like that, your grip gonna be more tired. When you completely open your wrist, you have a chance, half seconds maybe, get rest, take off stress from your grip. Okay, bottom position, it's a good interested point because that's how I'm saying, like, swings relate with snatch. Because I say always swing, snatch, it's about swings most of the time. It's about how you drop the bell. Pulling, you can pull in somehow, right? Like, it's not, it's really fast. You pull in the weights, you're gonna figure out naturally what's going on. Use your legs or use your back. But most stressed on your wrist, it's a bottom position. That's why we have to be really gentle when we drop the bell. We have to be really careful because grip, this is muscle, really not strong enough. Your legs stronger, your back stronger than your wrist anyway. It's mean we don't have to much worry about the legs or your back, but 100% focus it about your wrist, your grip. That's why bottom position, it's really important. That's why we master the swings. When we do swings, we know how, what's gonna happen when you're gonna do snatch. See, it's like a, right here. You drop it, okay. And back, let's break it down how you drop the bell from the top position. Okay, you make a swing, make a snatch, put kettlebells overhead on top, and you already drop the bell. What's happened? When you fixate the bell, you extend your knees, your hip a little bit back, and straight overhead position, straight line. But for shifting the weights, it's a different game, right? You understand, it's you just for get rest of your head. When you drop the bell, what's happened? You push forward your hip and extend your knees same time. I'm not do exactly like this. I do this really quick. That's why it's not really, you can not get knots exactly. I do this. I put hip forward and extend my knees a little bit and back to the swings position and catch the bell. See? It's like, look like this. And what's gonna happen here on top? Look. You push hip forward and unlock your knees, not extend your knees, unlock your knees. Unlock your knees, I said extend your knees when it's you extend, yes. Unlock your knees, bend your knees a little bit and kettlebell start fail. It's not necessarily should be vertical this way. It's going from the top, same as kettlebells. When kettlebells going up, it's a little bit from the side you rotate. Yes, it's when it's quick, it's going. When you do fast pace, it's going directly straight, vertical. But little bit you can get from the side. It's two options, from the side or vertical. But it's little bit going from the side because you don't wanna get this hit, right? What it's most beginners them do, like, and hit the wrist. That's why when you're learning from the little bit from the side, make sure you not hit your wrist. When you get more experience, you gonna do already really soft gonna be a really soft moment and you're not gonna hurt your wrist. Okay, top position. You push the hip forward, unlock your knees, and kettlebell start fail. A little bit from the side, and you always look at the straight line, right? And like a face position, or maybe even chest position, you get this position, right? You rotate the bell this way to 45 degrees position and try to up your elbow. See? It's like a bridge between top position and where you look it forward to going to this swings position right here. That's what you're looking forward, and you rotate the bell. And here, everything like a swings. And you drop it. Just let's do from the side. You drop it, and like a chest position, you do rotation. That's like a really trick, you have to do this fast. And elbow, not here. Make sure not elbow in the bottom. I know some, lot of different options people talk about. Keep your elbow closer to your body, but I'm respectfully disagree with this point because I'm explain why. Them talking about short distance, cut, make a distance short. Them thinking if you make a distance really short, you're gonna get less stress for your grip when you drop the bell, right here. Maybe you get less stress, but what about you have to put it kettlebells up? You need this pendulum, you need to accelerate, you need this moment to the make kettlebells fly. If you cut this distance, keep your elbow close to your body and drop the bell, it's gonna be less on the grip stress, but gonna be more stress when you put the kettlebells up. You need this moment. You see, you need this moment. You want this. If you make it short, it's not gonna change your, not make your snatch easy or your grip easy. That's why I'm always make a point, grip back to the swings position. Swings position, look. When you try first time, it's gonna be, you're always gonna be late. When this bridge right here, you're gonna be late and your elbow gonna be in a lower than kettlebells. Kettlebells gonna be a little bit higher. But it's about matter of practice. Elbow right here. Basically, when you drop the bell, you always look it forward to be in a swings position somehow. How, I'm show you already. Drop the bell and a chest position or a face, between face and chest position, you rotate the bell fast. And here, bottom position, you are strong because you master your swings all the time. You master your swings. You're not afraid. You know what's going on here. And you gentle catch and put it back. Put it back. Okay, breathing technique, it's the same when kettlebell's going up, it's inhale. But when you drop the bell, you catch exhale. And did you see if you need, maybe you're gonna stay 5-10 seconds overhead position It's no limit how long you're gonna stay to your head position. It's mean you get inhale, exhale, and you drop the bell. That's it.